emotional power base, if you like, in that her power was won vicariously through her husband. He was, as just said, Quinn was the, you know, the epitome of toxic masculinity, and was a very, very powerful figure, and her alliance with him, her association with him, was what gave her her status. So to me, what was very interesting was the loss of that, the fact that by the end of season one, she had lost him. I mean, she'd already lost him, because she was invisible to him. She'd lost her son, she'd lost her power, she'd lost everything that she had. And that's where, for me, it began to get interesting as a character, because just sometimes to lose everything can be the making of you. It's a very painful place to be, but it can mean that you can, if you accept it, if you truly accept that everything is gone and that you have to start over, sometimes it can make you understand who you actually are rather than who you thought you were. So for me, for season two and three, she came into her own strength. And by this season, season three, she has the daughter she never had and the daughter she always wanted with Tilda. And she has a lovely boyfriend in the form of Nathaniel Moon. I mean, happy day. So, you know.
Family right there.
So, yeah, it's a good journey. It's a beautiful journey to take.
Yeah, it will be really interesting to see how that resolves itself over the next 6 episodes. I will also say, Allie, I mean, I think the interesting thing about Tilda's character, she's sort of the moral core of like the Into the Badlands universe. And given that she's also, you know, out there kicking people's butts and, you know, expressing the gift and, you know, all this stuff going on, what was it like to play that role within the hurricane of this particular show?
I mean, the moral core of the Badlands would still fight, totally. Because, like, you can't not fight in the Badlands. But, yeah, it was amazing. Like, also because I was growing up with Tilda. I started the show when I was 16, and now I'm 21. So Tilda's journey has been growing up as a young girl, just like me, except in, like, a very different climate, with martial arts and with so many different influences, but I just absolutely love where Al and Miles have taken her, and it's been such an honor to play her and to get to experience like so many different things.
You know, it's